Jay, just like her. And you got these white, these weak men that's in power. She said, I'm not giving you nothing if you don't change that law. And this weak ass pass an unjust law against men. Those kind of people has to be uprooted or out of office, man. They got to go. Whatever it takes, man. The truckers are moving right. And now men have to take a stand. I'm not just talking the United States, man. I'm talking a worldwide movement, man. This is what we got to do, man. The petition is in the room. Sign the damn petition, man. Pass it all around. Then we orchestrate. We form some meetings. Then we march on Washington. We go into the Oval Offices and say to the legislators, we want these laws changed immediately. Immediately. No such thing. That tender laws doctrine is an unjust law. It needs to come off of the books. We don't want people in office anymore to have sovereign immunity when they're doing things that's unjust. We're all equal under the law. So your sovereign immunity needs to go. They get protected when they shouldn't be protected. They do unjust things to people, and they're protected under sovereign immunity, man. This has to stop, man. And you men, you're too quiet, man. You know what? You just talk and mourn, man. You're like a bunch of modern-day Eves, man. Just sit around and complain. And when I say, yo, let's ride, man.
Yeah, I'm busy, man. Yeah.
Get your weak ass up out of my face, man. Don't bring that around me, man. Now you got excuses. Become a secure party creditor, man. Protect your assets. Learn how to do liens. Your most powerful weapon, man, is that ink pen. That's my tender and it's my weapon. This is intellectual, man. This is spiritual, man. Stop trying to fight physical. You got your own people that's going to turn against you, man. Your own people are minions, man. That's how you deal with them, man. People in office that's doing unjust things, man. We have to set up a system where if one brother is going to court despite his color, we want a school, an army of people right there supporting them. Make sure it's justice. It's more of us than it is of them.
It's a fact.
Well, they just sit around and keep you divided. A simpleton. That's the stop, man. When will it stop? When are you guys going to man up? Sign the petition, man. Look what the truckers are doing. Use that as a catalyst for you to stop being weak. They're doing it to Donald Trump. They could do it to any of you, man. Any of you. It's a form online you could download. Protect your account from liens and levy, man. This happened to a lot of men. This stuff's been out there for a minute. I've been trying to teach men to do this. You're going to all of these people that don't know what the heck they're doing. If fails, then you want to try me. Nah, don't call me then, man. Call Tyrone. Because he's never picking up. He might be hanging out with Erykah Badu. He ain't never picking up.
Cool.
That's a fact, bro. That's a fact. So what are you going to do now? And by the way, I'm having a seminar in person. In Atlanta, Georgia. Already reserved the venue. So go ahead and book your seat. The link is in the room right now. It's going to be March the 23rd and 24th. Don't worry about the time. Why are you worried about the time? Just show up. What you going to try to fly in the same day? I'm going to hit you with something. If you wait late, if you get the ticket later than 25 hours is going up $50. You try and pay up the door, if there's any seats left, it's going to go up $50. So don't worry about the time, man. Don't ask me questions, man. The Negro always, oh, time, what time is it going to be? Just get there. That's the problem. You don't know the time, man. It's nation time, man. It's time that men, listen, this system has been going on too long against men, man. That's why the truckers are standing up. Because they realize, damn, they done that to Trump. Think about that, Kadar. This is a former president of the United States Corporation. They do it to him, they could do it to anyone, man. Someone like you and I don't stand a chance. But then, my power's in this. You see this thing right here, like this? With this, I could bring down governments. With this, I could bring down black robes. With this, I could bring down briefcases. Just with this, metal and ink. That's all I need, man. And in reverse, I can show you this is more powerful than a weapon. See, a man with a weapon, he might fire 16 rounds. And he might hit 16 people. A rogue with a weapon, with this weapon in my head, he puts away thousands throughout his career. Now stop me where I'm lying at. With ink and a pen, he puts you away for years. And it increases his pension in retirement, or her pension in retirement. Lots of times unjustly. They punish you in what they call a family court, which is an illegal court, by the way. See, this is why you guys got to come over here and really learn the law. I mean, the contract. Contract is law, right? Family court is an illegal court. Why is it illegal? Because according to the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, right? Sixth Amendment say, if it's criminal, you're entitled to a trial by jury. The Seventh Amendment says, if it's civil, you're entitled to a trial by jury if it's $20 or more. All trial support cases is above $20. Where's the jury? It's an unjust court. It goes against the Constitution. You're there because you consent. You consent to being part of this. Stop consenting, man. Stop consenting and stand up and get against it. We don't want to be tried in those kind of courts anymore. We demand to be tried in a court of a jury of our peers. Understand that. And not no damn tampered juries. And we want a court of record. A true court of record, according to Black Laws 4th, is absent of the person of the magistrate. Understand? That means there's no darn bench trial. The judge is just a referee, man. We got a jury of our peers. This is why you got to learn the law. I mean the contract, man. Do you understand? The pen is mightier than the sword. I know you heard it before, but the analogy I just gave you, you need to muse on it and now apply it. You understand what I'm saying, Chi? Now what? I just gave you guys some ammo. Now what? What are you going to do now? Got two guys on here. I sent the link to about four or five. None of them showed up. Scared. Now tell the doctor, there'd be more room if I played the bat. I'm going to let you talk. You damn right. Keep your coward ass over there. I sent the link to you too, Jeremiah Banks. I sent it to you, man. Stay in the background, man. Stay behind your damn mask. Keep on running like the running man. This is for real, man. Ain't no time for pump faking over here, man. Because all you pump fakers, you and me call out, man. This ain't no football game. And you ain't no damn quarterback. So stop pump faking. This is for the verb over here, man. So it's time, man, that men stand up and do something instead of just talking and complaining. All you do is, oh, man, yeah, they done me dirty there. Well, what did you do? What are you going to do now? How do we fix it?